And in it, I said, if you meet somebody and you really want to know what makes them tick, ask them about their childhood. What were they afraid of? How did they feel about their parents? What effect did their childhood have on them today? I asked, and they answered. These huge stars, Tom Cruise, Candace Bergen, David Letterman. Tom Cruise on how he learned to kiss. David Letterman on being a high school nerd. Candace Bergen, who never imagined she'd be a Murphy Brown when her father seemed to pay more attention to a wooden dummy. And when it comes to love and marriage, all three talk of having loved and lost and won. After tonight, I think you'll know them all better. Tom Cruise, Candace Bergen, David Letterman. Stay with us. For a man who's on television most every night, it's amazing how little anyone knows about David Letterman. A little over 10 years ago, he premiered a bold new show called Late Night, which featured consistently original and offbeat humor. Like him or not, David Letterman has forever changed television comedy.
That's the truth. Who are those women out there, by the way?
Neighbors.
I'll get rid of them. Hey. Excuse me. Just keep it moving. Come on, get the world, will you?
General Electric took over NBC and all of its broadcasting properties, and they started making cutbacks left and right. But fortunately, I must say, we've been very lucky here. It hasn't actually affected us too badly. Excellent. Hang on a second. This will just take a second. No, we've been very lucky, and they're actually not bad to work with. Of course, there have been kind of day-to-day little things that... There. That better, Hal?
A native of Indiana, Letterman's first show was a college radio program at Ball State University in Muncie. He parlayed that success into a job as a local TV personality in Indianapolis.
Once you take a look at the cloud cover photograph made earlier of the United States today.
Then moved to L.A., where he made a name for himself, first as a comedy writer, then as a stand-up comic.
Thank you, son. We've learned a valuable lesson there. Not everyone can do comedy. I appreciate it.
He first stepped into the mainstream with the short-lived variety show Mary, starring Mary Tyler Moore.
There she is, Mary Tyler Moore, eating her cornflakes.
Oh. You up, please, David Letterman. David.
But as with so many young comics, the big break was on The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson.
Kind of thing I always remember as long as I live, growing up in Indiana, is when Dad used to tease me with the power tools. How many of you? Did you have that? What a guy.
What a guy. Sense of humor.
Yeah.
In David Letterman, Johnny Carson found a kindred spirit who consistently made him laugh.
Yeah.
After an NBC morning show on which Letterman flopped, Carson's production company found him a spot on Late Night and a place in television history.
Air Major, the Flying Dog.
His personal life is, to say the least, low profile. If it weren't for that unfortunate woman who's continually breaking into his Connecticut home, we'd never read anything about him. We do know he married young, divorced, and had for a while a serious romance with Meryl Marco, the original head writer on his show. I was nervous myself about interviewing Letterman. I'd read that he had a long grievance list with his employers at NBC, and that he could be ultra shy and very guarded. But he was nice, relaxed, and answered everything. One of your quotes from a past interview is, some people are born not to be happy people. I am one of them.
I don't think I said that. Did I say that?
Quote, unquote.
Oh, I must have been miserably drunk.
Miserably drunk. Yes, well, speaking of miserably drunk.
Geez, I really said that?
Yeah.
Wow.
The childhood in Indiana. Happy memories?
Largely, yeah, happy memories.
Middle child.
Right.
You know what we hear about middle children.
Raised by poodles. Did you know that? Is that in your notes?
No, I didn't know that. That's nice. Yeah. Yeah.
No, I had a great childhood. It was, I wish I had something to complain about. I mean, I had an older sister and a younger sister and mom and dad and played Little League baseball and had a tree house, you know, dropped out of school in the fourth grade and ran away.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Was tortured by circus people.
Right.
Found me naked wandering in the desert six weeks later. Other than that, it was okay.
Yeah, well, those are things I'll just overlook. But you were not a cool kid when you were in school. You were
just a jerk.
You were
just
a nerd.
A goofball, yeah.
Yeah, but now you're so, don't get upset,
just, no,
but
I'm just
you're
a
so
jerk
cute.
And a
Why were you such a nerd then?
I still think, I it's just, some people, I think, Barbara, are born not to be happy.
Where have I heard that? Your dad was a florist. Did you like him? Were you close to him?
I think close. I mean, he had to work really hard, and he worked long hours. He was a small business owner, and worked holidays, and 6 days a week. And so we weren't as close. I think we had a pretty good relationship, and I did like him. He was of the family. He was the goofball. He was the
funny.
Yeah. Funny and kind of a, oh, Dad, stop it, kind of funny. And you know, oh, it's Dad, it's goofy Dad again, stop it. You're making us, oh, Dad. And then we'd hide under the house for weeks at a time. Everybody says this, but you walk by a mirror now, and sometimes you catch, you say, oh, geez, that's what my dad used to look like. And it's satisfying, you know.
And your mother.
Oh, don't get me.
Oh, let's talk about mother.
Oh.
Mother who never really had any great interest in show business.
No, to her credit. Yeah. A very nice woman. For 6 years was the equipment manager for the Buffalo Sabres.
Yes.
Talk about mom. And is I think as happy or happier now in her life than she's ever been.
Do you remember your first appearance on The Tonight Show?
Yep. And it was at the time, and probably will, regardless of what happens, be one of the, if not the most satisfying moment for me in big-time television.
Because you did well with Johnny?
Yeah. Yep, it was, it took me weeks to unwind.
Huh.
It was very exciting, and not much since has come even close to that.
There was the morning show that you did at NBC.
That's right.
Okay. You can still laugh.
Yeah, at the time it was awfully painful, the experience. And in show business, and I guess just like any other business, you think, well, now I've got to go to the end of the line, and who knows whether or not my number will be called again.
What did you do that year?
I fought with my girlfriend.
Well, that killed a few
And the time
hours.
Just flew by.
You know, you mentioned your girlfriend, but... one of the things that isn't that well known about you is that you were married when you were in college for mm-hmm. 7 years?
Right.
And broke up?
No, it was 9 years.
9 years.
Yeah, I got married in college, and madly in love with this beautiful woman. And then I went a little nuts and misbehaved, and it came apart. But I think that it's my own doing, or my own undoing.
Want to get married again?
Yes.
Someone in your life right now?
Yes.
Someone you want to marry?
Yeah.
Someone you want to tell us about?
Like what do you want to know?
Well,
height, weight, kind of thing?
Name, who she is, and are you really going to get married?
It's hard for me to imagine myself not being married again. Because, you know, I would like to have a family. The fact that I was married early and for a long time and that it came apart is sort of like a warning to me that has stayed with me, and I'm not eager to get married again and have another one come apart, so I'm taking my time.
Have you asked her?
Ask her to what?
Marry you.
I've asked her to drop the topic.
You've asked me to drop the topic.
No, I spent a great deal of my time saying, let's talk about that later. What's for dinner?
She was somebody who used to work with you.
Yeah.
Is that, you don't want to say more?
No, what, I mean, you know, I got enough people moving in at my house as it is, so let's...
Well, what about that woman who kept breaking into your house?
There's nothing funny about it.
No, there's nothing funny about it.
There's nothing funny about it, and it was at a time when I didn't really live in that house. Mm-hmm. I lived, all my free time I was living in California.
This was a house in Connecticut.
Yeah, still is a house in Connecticut. And spending all of my free time in California, and got a call one night from my assistant. She had been notified by the police that somebody had been picked up at the at a tunnel or a bridge crossing at the Hudson in my car with a young child claiming to be my wife. And I mean, it sounds amusing, but the sadness of it is you get to see firsthand